Child's behavior, both good and not just bad, but good too. Between weekly sessions, the parents practice what they learn and report to the therapist on their progress. Basically, parent training is about carrots and sticks, says Brady. On the carrot end, you work on giving your child praise and rewards for cooperating. Lay out clear consequences and behavior, usually involving a timeout or the removal of you have to have rewards there in order to remove. So you're up on your rewards. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Buy that good stuff and then take it away when it's necessary. Parent management training is often highly effective. Now, check this out, highly effective. With the child's behavior improving dramatically in 4 out of 5 cases, it's literally 80% of the people who try this succeed. Parents who undergo the training typically report greater marital satisfaction. You want marital satisfaction? You and your spouse to be like this? Go for parent management training, okay? Parents who undergo the training typically great American satisfaction, as well as improving behavior for other children. So, go through the parent management training, help one child, other children get help. You know what I'm saying? While some parents balk at the notion that they are the ones that need a training. Yeah. Have to learn how to stop getting into the arena with the child and descending to the level of squabbling. Says Lil, parents often feed the problem by delivering overly harsh or inconsistent discipline. So you're doing too much, okay? Or you're inconsistent. Nah, I won't do it now. I'll do it later. Do it now, every time, consistently. Instead, parents must reassert their authority by setting up well-defined rewards and punishments, and then implementing them consistently and dispassionately. I stopped right there. I said, what's the passion? That's why I started this video. It came full circle. I did not see that. I've never seen that one. I love it. I look like a media. Unemotional, rational. We'll be right back. impartial, calm. See that right there? Calm. Come on, parents. We can do that. Start learning as parents, we're not thinking about how it makes us feel about ourselves. It's not about us. It's about doing the best for our children. Okay? Parents often face problems by delivering overly harsh or inconsistent discipline, and good parents must reassert their authority and with well-defined rewards and punishments. And then implementing my most important rule is that parents should not take ODD behavior personally. Remain calm and friendly whenever you intervene. Oppositional students have radar for hostility. If you pick up your anger, they're going to match it. Riley recommends a 2 request for me. First time you ask your child to do something, give them 2 minutes to respond. What? Too long. Unless he doesn't obey, calmly tell him, I'm not asking him to time. To pick up his coat? You need 2 minutes for that? Oh. 2 minutes? Got a lot of room to run. Got a lot of, giving them a lot of rope. Dang, they still going. Two whole minutes. I guess, but if I can't you're out. Warning is going to be more funny than bad news. Isn't a revolution of the content. I'm just kidding. Easier said than done. Parents must rein in their amongst friends. At the same time, must learn how to substitute non-adversive punishment. Time out for loss of privilege. Many parents of opposition feel so focused on bad behavior that they stop reinforcing positive ones. You'll see it. But positive reinforcement is the hardest thing to parent manage with training. Invariably, parents come to treatment with the idea of suppressing, limiting, using problem behavior, writes Ellie Kasdan, PhD in parent management training. A manual for therapists. But according to Kasdan, director of Yale University's Child Studies in New Haven, Connecticut, parent training emphasizes the concept of positive opposites. Instead, for example, said Kasdan, parents are asked what to do if they want their child to stop slamming the door, or throwing breakable objects. The answers involve reinforcing talking quietly, closing the door gently, handling objects with control. It maintains that helping parents learn and praise good behavior is one of the toughest challenges they're facing. Because parents are often hesitant to praise a behavior, or to use reinforcements in general, because they feel the behavior often does not require any intervention. A child knows how to clean up his room. He just refuses to do it. How parents can offer more effective praise to a defiant child. When parents do offer praise, they should be enthusiastic. An unenthusiastic statement of good is not likely to change. Praiseworthy behavior.
Tell me you love me.
Include some nonverbal gestures. For example, you might say, "The wonderful way you played so quietly while I was on the phone." And give your child a kiss. Appropriate words and punishment. More creatively you take your child's specific ability to meet better, that is true. Because I can just get it silently. And it works with one child without another. Like my babies, I can't put a thumb up, but my own brain, I can. Creativity is always an asset to child rearing. Consistency in the way you treat your child, the way you set rules, convey expectations, pay attention, encourage good behavior, and impose consequences for everyone. It's key to cleaning up your child's life. Never lose sight of the fact that opposition kids usually have a great deal to offer. Once their behavior is under control, oppositional people are often quite engaging and bright. That's why they tend to be optimistic and very much their own person with their own way of looking at the world. Once you walk through their defiance, there's a lot to bear. Good job. Guys, go over and check it out. Thank you. was in 2010. Okay. All right, we're about to put this on YouTube, this video, okay?